The delay a little bit. I guess we're having connectivity issues, so I hope we're going to be fine. So today we're going to be talking about gratitude and practicing gratitude during difficult times. Now, this is something actually that I've been thinking about all week. Reason being that we had a major bereavement, a loss in my family, and the minute that you have a loss like that, it tends to bring everything into a perspective. And those are the times when, we need to figure out, who we are and what we're thinking about. So, when we think about gratitude, gratitude is easy during difficult times, isn't it? I mean, you can always think about your blessings and say, I'm grateful that I have this or that. However, it is a different story when something difficult happens, right? Whether it's an economic loss or a bereavement or a difficult, whatever difficulty it is, it tends to detract us, right? And obviously, it's a bit like this, it's a bit like this this diagram where you see white paper, but it's like, for example, the white is like all your life, and the black dot is the trial or the difficulty that you face. And what happens when we have a black dot like this? All our attention goes to the black dot. Now, if I hadn't described it, you would have looked at this and just seen the black dot. You wouldn't have seen any of the, or you wouldn't really notice the white background. You'd just think, okay, there's a piece of paper with a black dot on it. So that's pretty much what happens when we have a difficulty arise. We tend to, our focus tends to become very myopic, and we just go into that. Now, that is actually very natural. Like, so when you have a serious difficulty arise, especially now with all the lockdowns or other things, economic crises that people are facing, it's very natural and normal for us to just become myopic about that and just go right into the problem. And that's actually very natural because we are feeling unsettled. We are feeling that a major issue has occurred, which it has, and we have to deal with the crisis at hand. So it's very, very actually normal that we would have a reaction like that. We would be suffering, and automatically we would go, okay, this is a crisis that I have to deal with. And if it's not that, then first it's all the mechanics of it. Then we have the grieving process, which is also natural, and we're also dealing with the shock of the situation. So, if you're not, it do not, it's not natural to expect ourselves to be grateful right in the first moment. It's very rare that we'd be able to see, something good right from the get-go. That's not natural. But so it's okay. It's okay for us to feel a bit unsettled and feel the nerves and feel all of that. So if you're in that space, I just want to say that that's okay. It's natural. It's normal. It happens. But then what? Like, what do you do after that initial shock has settled and the reactive time is over? That is when, the key, that's the window that we're actually talking about. So once the shock settles, it's very, very easy. And we can all be victim to this why me? Why did this have to happen to me? Why are these difficulties coming upon me? Why am I having to face this? We can go into this kind of self-pity mode, and we have to be really, really careful about that because that can kind of prolong itself. So what do I mean by this? What I mean is that the more we go into that mode, the more of that we will notice and the more of that we will get because the mind is a filter. So you pretty much get what you put in. So if you put in, something good, you get out something good. Very much like nutrition. Like if you eat poorly, your health suffers. So the mind and the body are very much the same system. So if we allow ourselves to fall into that rabbit hole, we can kind of get stuck there. And when we are actually feeling bad about ourselves, we know we're comparing, right? So it's okay. I mean, we compare all the time, but at that point, we're comparing as sort of what others have and what we don't have. So just imagine a glass of water in front of you that is got water up to half. And, you know, you might show it to somebody and they might go, oh, you know, this is a glass half empty. Or you might say, oh, this is a glass half full. In fact, I had one of my teachers long ago show this to me. And I think he was trying to teach me a lesson. He said, what is this? I said, it's a glass of water. And he said, well, is it half full or what is it? So I said, it's half full. And he said, oh, I thought you'd say it's half empty. I said, well, why would you say that? You know, anyway, that was a different story. So our attention often in situations like this can become with what we don't have. It can become a situation of scarcity. And this is where, you know, we may develop the glass half empty thinking. So this is where we need to be a little bit more careful. And this is not about being sad. Okay, sadness is a different situation, and what I'm talking about is different. Sadness can be very, very productive, but that's really not our discussion right now. So coming back to this, how do we deal with the difficult times through gratitude? Like, how do we break out of that feeling bad for ourselves and feeling sorry for ourselves? How do we stay in gratitude, right? That is actually really, really important, because if we can stay in gratitude, there are a lot of different things that we actually get out of that. Now, let me talk about some of the benefits of gratitude. Like, why be grateful in the first place? Does it, you know, is it worth it? You know, is it worth it? So when we actually practice gratitude, and I'll define it in a moment, when we actually practice gratitude, a lot of things happen. First, it actually boosts the feel-good chemicals in our brains, right? The neurotransmitters that you may have heard of, dopamine and serotonin, these are like the brain's reward pathways. So it's like when you get a reward, like for example, if you eat something really enjoyable, you feel good for a while. It's those similar chemicals. So it actually creates a real feeling of wellness, and it promotes that feeling of well-being, which we really, really want, right? So what that also does is it helps to regulate our moods. It helps to keep our sleep patterns better. It also helps us to build better connections with other human beings. That's what gratitude also does. Isn't that amazing? So it helps us to be more compassionate as well. It helps boost our metabolism. So generally, there are a lot of wonderful things that gratitude does. And also with a lot of these situations, difficult situations, we sometimes tend to fall into depression. Now, if we are feeling sorry for ourselves, that may happen. I'm not talking about clinical depression here, please, because that is an illness. We're not discussing that. But we're just talking about, you know, when we tend to feel really down and we tend to stay there. So when we actually focus on gratitude, it helps again to keep us focused on the present. It helps us to see what good we have in our lives right now. And in that way, it combats the blues. So we feel amazing. And it helps to calm the fight flight response. So imagine you've had this struggle, you've had this difficulty, so you've had this fight flight response. And then the gratitude will really help to bring that, you know, and calm you down, calm your system down. It increases our empathy and compassion for other people, because when we're in a thankful state, we want to be good to others. It's just a natural response that we tend to have. And it's also, I was doing some research, it's also very good for illness, especially for heart patients. It says that it reduces the inflammatory biomarkers that are, you know, damaging to heart health. And it reduces fatigue, it keeps our energy levels going. So a lot of things are come out of this, and it helps us be more resilient. So when we do have difficulties, we tend to bounce back much faster when we are actually